Yo, what is up, every freaking buddy? Welcome back to another video, another day out here in the desert. I'm just kind of chilling here at the house. And, obviously, as you can tell by the title of today's video, we're going to be talking about the Colorado River, how to fish it, what to do, and kind of start breaking this thing down for you. Because I know a lot of you guys here want to, a lot of you guys here and maybe other places too want to fish the river. You just don't know how. So, it's very broad. There's a lot of information I have up in this brain right here, in this noggin. And I want to share it with you guys. But before we get into all of that, before we get into the juiciness, I do want to say that I did quit my job, people. I did quit my freaking job. I just couldn't stand my boss anymore, and I'm a cool people's, you know, I'm a cool person. I work hard, I bust my ass, and this dude, I just couldn't work with him no more, and that, I had to do it, and so now I'm really just gonna go balls to the wall with this YouTube thing, and I really want, you know, for this channel to take off, you know, to the next level, and man, I don't have my hat. It's freaking warm out here, man. So pretty much, if you guys want to, you know, support the channel, I'm going to put, you know, PayPal, Cash App, all those links down in the description below. So that way, if you guys want to donate anything to the channel, you guys totally can. And pretty much go from there. And also, I do have a plan with these videos. Before we start talking about more information, I have a plan for these videos. I kind of want to make maybe like a membership thing. So that way, you guys can subscribe to that. And it's not going to be real expensive just because I understand life. I know how it is. My only thing is, you know, I work real hard for this information that I have and knowledge of fishing, and to just give it out is hard, you know, enough to do with videos. But I want everyone to catch fish. I want people to catch their PBs. I want people to fish the Colorado River and overall enjoy it. Why would I want you guys to go over there and get skunk? Handing out the information, you know, in detail, in actual depth, is something that it's like the fisherman in me wants to teach everybody, but the fisherman in me also knows that if I just give away spots, that if I just tell you where to go and what to throw, that you're not learning nothing. You guys gotta learn, you know, and you guys gotta go out there and put time in, and that's literally the best way to freaking learn. I'll do these videos, you know, I'll do a couple of them, you know, so that way you guys can kind of see if you want to subscribe to this. But I do plan, this is my first time doing this too, so I'm gonna be learning with you guys, and I'm gonna also be, you know, doing my very best, you know, to break it down. But so that's my plan, that's my future plan for these videos, is to make a membership so that way you guys can subscribe, and I'm gonna give you guys details. I do want to break the Colorado River down for you guys, and you, by you guys supporting that, I'll be able to put gas in my truck. I'll be able to get out to the river. I'll be able to do all this stuff every single day. So that way you guys have like an up-to-date breakdown of the river. And I want to make these videos quite frequent, maybe one to twice a week. And let me know if that's something you guys be willing to do. You know, the more you guys interact with me, the more I'm going to interact with you guys. And if you just comment yes down below. But yeah, for the most part, that's my goal. That's my ultimate goal with this. And so without, you know, boring you guys with all that BS and stuff, let's talk about the Colorado River. You know, a lot of people like to show up to the river. They love to pull up and be like, oh man, we're gonna catch a 10 pounder. And that's the correct mindset you should have. If you're not having that mindset, like, hey, I'm gonna catch a big ass fish, just go home, just leave, just don't even show up, okay? But a lot of you Phoenix dudes, a lot of you California dudes, you like to show up and you look at it, and don't get me wrong, you look at it and you're like, man, this whole place looks really good. Now that's the trick, you know, that's the problem. Is the whole entire Colorado River looks awesome to fish. The main part of this video that I want you guys to take away from is before we even start talking about what baits to throw, where to go, how to do this and that, I need you guys to understand weather. The weather not only consists of outside air, it consists of water temperatures, it consists of moon phases, and it also consists of, you know, understanding how weather affects fish. Pretty much weather affects fish, and those fish, depending on the weather, do certain things. So if you guys can understand that, then you guys are gonna have an easy time, you know, learning from these videos. So pretty much right now, it's March. We are still currently in a, I would say, pre-spawn to maybe spawning mode, okay? And you guys have to understand that the Colorado River is affected by everything. That is one ecosystem that is constantly changing every single freaking day. One day it could be 2 feet high, it could be 2 feet low. So when you think weather, don't just think outside air, think everything, you know? why is this, maybe the sun's right here, maybe the sun's real high, you know, morning, low, it could literally be anything. So if you're gonna fish the river and you're not having a good morning, like, okay, hey, maybe the evening bite's on, okay, let's go on the evening. You try the same thing and maybe you catch fish like that, okay? But definitely understanding your weather patterns and how it works and everything is gonna help you catch a lot more fish. It really, really will. I am always on weather.com. You guys can go on weather.com and look up the weather. And I always do the 10-day forecast so that way I can see if the daytime temperatures are holding and climbing, as well as the nighttime temperatures. You want to definitely keep track of the nighttime ones, just because nighttime is when things cool down. So if you have this humongous spike going down, you know, at night, it's gonna chill the water a little bit more, and therefore it's gonna affect the fishing. Sometimes it puts them into like a little pre-spawn mode. So what that means is that when it gets cold, guys, fish congregate. They look for grass, they look for deep water, and they all school up and they want to eat. They want to get real fat, so that way when the water starts warming back up and they get ready for the spawn, they're going to be nice, big, fat, and healthy. And so a lot of them, they're going to have their eggs and stuff. They're going to eventually do their thing. And that's the time that we're in right now. This is springtime fishing. You know, this happens all across the country very differently. I know in Florida, it happens first, and then it comes like in a wave across Texas. But Texas got frozen over this year, you know, thanks to global warming. You have that cold front coming into Texas when usually the fish are getting ready to spawn. So like I said, that weather can move this way. You can have a hurricane on the East Coast and it's gonna affect us eventually. You can have, like how we just had the last week actually, we had cold wind from the north blow in, and that shut the fish back down because they're getting ready to spawn, because the daytime temperatures were up in the 86 degree mark, holding for a few days. The nighttime temperatures were climbing, and then boom, it shut back off. It went down, so now the fish are gonna be pushing up. They're gonna kind of be moving. They're gonna be like staging in and out. And then the other thing with the Colorado River is you have different backwaters, guys. Every single backwater is gonna be different. It's gonna vary in temperature. It's gonna vary in water depth and clarity. The dirtier the water is, the faster it's gonna warm up. That's just a big common, you know, knowledge rule, but some people may not know that. You know, clear water tends to warm up a little bit slower, but if the clear water is more shallow than the dirtier water, well, the shallow water is probably gonna be a little bit more warm. So in every backwater you ever go to at the river, it's gonna be different, guys. So that's why I really wanna stress weather. Before we even talk about baits, which will be in another video, I want you guys to really do your homework, and every time you go fishing, buy a calendar. This is what I do, is I buy a calendar. Every time I catch, you know, a solid fish, I write down on that calendar, I'm like, hey, okay, I caught a fish this time. This was the moon phase, okay? And then once you start, you know, putting little patterns together of where you, and it doesn't have to just be here, but I do want to teach you guys how to fish the river, so mine is the river. But for wherever you guys are at, you know, keep track of that weather. You know, is the wind blowing this way or is the wind blowing that way? Am I in this channel? Is there any current? Is there any rocks down at the bottom? Because that's another video too, you know, structure and stuff and what to look for at the river. But I really am stressing weather, because a lot of people always go out fishing. They're like, I didn't catch anything. There's some days I don't even go out fishing, you know, because you've been staying on top of the bite. You know how it's changing. You see what they're doing. And when they shut off, they shut off. Like, I mean, from the end of the river all the way to the beginning of the river, like as far as I've been, you know, like fish will just shut off completely. But yeah, I really want to stress weather on you guys. So in this video, you guys are probably like, why am I gonna pay for this? And I'm like, dude, it's gonna get better, guys. Like, I'll make the videos actually out on the river while I'm there. But like I said, I'm just starting to do this, so I'm learning with you, so this might not be the best one. What I ask of you guys is buy a calendar, you know, put it on your phone, write down the daytime temperatures, maybe take a screenshot or something, the daytime and the nighttime temperatures, look at the moon phases, look up Tactical Bassin. They have so many more videos on how to fish, but not specifically the Colorado River. But once you understand like weather and fishing and how it affects the fish, look all that stuff up, because then I'm gonna start talking about baits and stuff and what to throw and where to go and what to look for. But weather is something that I literally can't stress enough, guys. Like, you guys gotta understand that, like, there'll be days where I don't wanna fish a tournament just because I know how it's gonna be. Like, when I say keep track of everything, keep track of literally, go crazy, like become insane, start becoming obsessed with it. Like, cause if you're not obsessed with it and you're gonna go out there every single time and be like, eh, nah, it's like, it's gonna suck today, you know? So just always keep track of weather, keep track of, you know, what am I doing wrong? Like, what am I throwing that's wrong? And like I said, we'll talk about baits later, but for the most part, just try to understand you guys' you know, weather, like, but even at the river, like if you're fishing it, is the water low or is the water high? And every backwater, like I said, is gonna be different too. Is the water cloudy or is the water clear? Is it deep? How deep is it? What's the water temperature? You know, if you don't have electronics like me, I still catch fish. I still go out and I figure it out. There'll be a guy out on the boat and I'll be like, hey dude, what's the water temperature? 60 degrees. And 60 degrees, the magic number for spawning fish is 65 degrees. I'm pretty sure that's what it is. It's not 74, because that's just too high. I think I've said 74 to somebody before, so I was wrong in that. So 65 is what you're looking for. But that's the magic number when fish are just gonna push up onto the bank and then they're gonna start really, really trying to, you know, lay their eggs and stuff. Right now in pre-spawn, I'd say it's the best time to fish any time of the year, just because when the fish school up, they're ready to feed, they wanna eat. The water's just right below that mark where they, right before they're gonna, you know, start doing their thing. And then once they snap out of it, they don't wanna bite anything. Like right now at the river, I know down south, a bunch of fish are in tules, a bunch of fish are in those deeper lakes, just because they're coming from that deep water, moving into that warmer water. You know, the deeper the water is, you know, the colder it's gonna be. So they're staging. It's called staging. So fish congregate in the middle, and then they move up, and then right now you can literally go to the lake and there's hundreds of freaking 6-pounders all in the tules, you know, 3-4 pounders. You're gonna have these little small fish too. Those are your male bass, and they're gonna start fanning out beds because that water temperature is gonna start rising. So I'd say by the end of March we're gonna be, you know, maybe over or full of spawning mode. So it literally just varies from backwater to backwater, but keep in mind, like, what am I fishing? Where am I fishing? Am I down south? Am I up north? Am I in the middle of the river? Moon phases, you know, the full moon usually affects them if they're gonna spawn or not. So we just had a cold front and a full moon. Full moon is gonna probably happen again, you know, this month by the end of it. And I think that's the one that's really gonna trigger them to just really push up real hard and do their thing. And when they do, you know, you're gonna have a bunch of big fish everywhere. It's the easiest time to catch fish. Personally, I don't like fishing during the spawn. I think it's stupid, honestly. People go, I caught a 10 pounder. I'm like, no, you didn't, dude. Like, anybody could have caught that. You didn't work for it. And, you know, this is just my opinion, you know. But like I said, for today's video, we're gonna keep it simple. Just keep track of the weather, guys. It can go a long way in your next fishing tournament, in your next fishing excursion, your next fun fishing trip or whatever. Keep it simple today. Keep track of your weather. You guys are gonna start catching more fish. Today's video is a little bit more informative than you know, the other ones that I make. And I do have some more videos coming out for you guys. And so I'm super excited. And like I said, you know, hopefully we can make this into like a membership thing, just because I'm real sad just because I don't want to give you guys information, but I want to give you guys legit actual information of what's happening like week to week. And so that's why, you know, I'm gonna want to make that happen. And if I can, you know, I'm gonna need some funds for that. And it would literally be supporting me and the entire channel. I'm not trying to like skimp you guys out and trying to take your money and become this and that. I genuinely want to put this money back into the channel. So if you guys want to support, hit the PayPal, hit the Cash App, hit all these Venmo, whatever, all these links down below. I truly, really would appreciate it, guys. And like I said, I'll make a couple more videos informational, and then so that way you guys could be like, all right, you know, maybe this stuff will work and maybe I will subscribe to this. But I want to make it worth your time, because I genuinely appreciate every single one of you that does support me. When you guys comment, you know, when you guys like the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and you know, you guys send it to another person. I really do appreciate that. I want people to catch fish. I want people to catch their PBs. But yeah, thank you guys all for watching today's video. Study your weather for the time being and go from there. Have a wonderful day, homies, and fish on.